SpaceX is preparing to launch SN15, a new iteration of its interplanetary rocket, after 4 successful test flights of its next-generation Starship prototypes all ended in dramatic explosions during the landing phase. So, when will SN15 launch, and what can we expect from the latest Starship prototype? Make sure you watch until the end of the video, because today we will be talking about the expected launch date of the Starship prototype SN15. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. On March 30th, 2021, the same day as Starship SN11's foggy, ill-fated launch debut, Musk announced that the SN15 will include hundreds of design improvements across structures, avionics, software, and engine. SpaceX accelerated work on its latest Starship prototype SN15 almost immediately after the mid-air explosion of Starship SN11. Work on the Starship SN15 was intensified in an apparent attempt to meet Musk's stated deadline of a few days to roll the rocket to the launch pad. Not long after, on April 8th, Starship prototype SN15 was moved to the launch site. SN15 passed the pressure test with room temperature nitrogen the next day. 3 days later, on April 12th, SpaceX performed a cryogenic test on the main tanks, and a day later, the header tanks underwent the same process. In the hopes of a successful outcome, Elon Musk has announced that the SN15 flight test will take place next week. His tweet on April 15th read, "Aiming to launch next week." The Starship is currently undergoing the installation of a new Raptor engine. Since the latest thrust puck required to be tested using a thrust simulator, the Raptor engines are yet to be mounted on SN15. Now, before you Google, thrust puck is a steel plate attached to the aft dome's bottom. It includes Raptor engine mounts, TVC systems, and fuel line components. The new design of SN15 features far fewer fuel lines, and TVC is now directly attached to the thrust puck. The thrust simulator was removed on April 14th, and SN15 is now waiting for 3 sea-level Raptor engines to be installed. Elon Musk, the founder of SpaceX, is pushing for rapid development of the system to fly passengers around the moon in 2023, land NASA astronauts on the lunar surface in 2024, and establish cities on Mars in the 2030s as an ultimate goal, and the key to achieve his long-term goals. Starship, a stainless steel spacecraft that SpaceX is designing, intended to launch cargo and up to 100 people at a time. SpaceX has completed 4 Starship test flights to date, all of which ended in a fiery explosion. Despite all the challenges, SpaceX seems unfazed. The Starship test campaign is more than just a way for SpaceX to learn how to fly and land the aircraft. As per the statement of SpaceX, test flights are all about improving our understanding and development of a fully reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo on long-duration interplanetary flights and help humanity return to the moon and travel to Mars and beyond. The most recent launch of Starship prototype SN11 on 30 March concluded with a rapid, unscheduled disassembly after a methane leak hindered the landing procedure of the next-generation craft. SN11 took off at precisely 8 a.m. Central Daylight Time, CDT, from Boca Chica, Texas, but was totally obscured by a dense layer of fog. While fog poses no real threat to rockets like Starship, SN11 took advantage of the opportunity to test new and exciting failure modes just before touchdown. Everything went smoothly as the SN11 ascended to a height of around 6.2 miles and then fell back to Earth. However, after SN11 completed its signature flip maneuver in preparation for a landing burn and soft landing, onboard cameras froze during the SpaceX live stream. Luckily, other nearby remotely controlled live stream cameras filmed an orange glow in the fog, accompanied by a flood of debris raining down on the exclusion zone around the landing pad. Unlike the 3 earlier prototypes, SN11 exploded in midair. Nobody knew what exactly had happened to the SN11 until Musk shared some details on what happened in SN11's final moments. Musk tweeted, A relatively small methane leak led to fire on engine 2 and fried part of avionics, causing hard start attempting landing burn in methane turbopump. He added, SN15 rolls to launch pad in a few days. It has hundreds of design improvements across structures, avionics, software, and engine. Hopefully, one of these improvements covers the problem. If not, then retrofit will add a few more days. SpaceX is rapidly launching its prototypes one after another in the hopes of achieving a smooth launch and landing. The Starship prototype SN15 has already undergone some initial testing over the last week, and Musk tweeted that the aim is to launch next week. Road and beach closures are planned for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Pacific Time, noon to 8 p.m. Central Time, each day around the SpaceX Starship production facility in Boca Chica, Texas. Now, several new changes were spotted on 360-degree views of the rocket after it was rolled out on the launch pad, one of them being the STARLINK internet dish. SpaceX has installed a STARLINK receiver on its new Starship prototype SN15, providing high-speed internet connectivity to the Mars-bound rocket. Simply put, STARLINK is a satellite internet constellation being constructed by SpaceX that will provide access to the internet via satellite. STARLINK is not being designed to support people who live in densely populated areas. The idea is to provide internet access to areas where it has previously been unreliable or entirely inaccessible. SpaceX wants to keep extending the STARLINK network until it has near global coverage of the inhabited world in 2021. For Musk, both Starlink and Starship will prove crucial to colonizing Mars, with the former potentially funding the development of the latter. Elon Musk has stated that the Space Internet Project will be used to finance his goal of colonizing Mars by 2050. While SN15 is undergoing its final testing, Starship prototypes SN16 through SN20 are currently under construction. SN16's tank section is currently undergoing stacking inside the midbay. In a photo snapped by RGV Aerial Photography, one tank section of this prototype was seen fully covered in heat tiles. Both SN17 and SN18 also have several components prepared. Musk plans to create up to 100 starships a year, each with the capacity to hold up to 100 people. Crewed flights could begin as soon as next year, with the first commercial flight scheduled for 2023. In a recent tweet, Musk addressed the current plans of SpaceX, confirming that Starship designs from SN20 onward would be orbit-capable and feature even more upgrades. His tweet read as, "Next major technology rev is at SN20. Those ships will be orbit-capable with a heat shield and stage separation system. Ascent success probability is high. However, SN20-plus vehicles will probably need many flight attempts to survive Mach 25 entry heating and land intact." SpaceX has already completed 4 major high-altitude flight tests since December as part of a massive testing program, all of which ended in a fiery explosion. And hopefully, the Starship prototype SN15 will be able to break the cycle of failure. Within the time frame given by SpaceX, SN15 could launch at any time or not at all. We normally don't know exactly when it will blast off until less than an hour before it does, and even then, false starts are normal. Right now, all you can do is cross your fingers and wish that SN15 can take flight and land. If you liked this video, you may also enjoy the next video, SN15 Raptors, that is shown in the end screen. See you there!